everyone. Welcome to the next session of the OpenEducat. In this session, I am going to show you how to import the data. But first of all, let's log in into the system using your username and password. I am entering my username and password. Click on the login. But first of all, why the import of this data is important? Just consider one situation that one campus is there, and under that campus different courses are there, like management, it's BSc, BCom, then engineering, and under that courses of course different batches are there, and under that batches of course students are there. So creating that course, creating that batch, and creating that students are of course time consuming na, and of course it's a ridiculous work. Then what's the solution? The solution is OpenEducat. So forget about your problem, and now I'm going to solve your problem using OpenEducat. So I'm going to discuss this data in four steps. First of all, I'm going to import the data of the courses. Second, I'm going to enter the data of batches. Third, I'm going to import the data of subjects. And fourth, I'm going to import the data of students one by one. So let's jump to the first step. That's step number one, how to import the data of courses. For that, click on this OpenEducat. Now click on this configuration and courses. Under the courses, different courses are there. But I am going to import the data of only two courses, which is Computer Science Semester 3 and Computer Science Semester 5. Further, click on this favorites, click on this import records. Here you can see that there is a two options are there. First one is load file and second one is cancel. I have to click this load file, but for that I need one template. So there is an option for import template for courses. I am click on this. Already one template is downloaded. I am going to open it. Now this template is already open. Now I am going to add the data of that particular two courses. Now I'm going to add that course, which is Computer Science Semester 3. It's a code and it's evolution type, which is GPA. I'm going to add the another course, Computer Science Semester 5. It's code and it's evolution type. I'm going to save this template and jump to the main screen. Going to load this file, which is course. Now that file is of course loading. Here you can see four options: import, test, load new file, and cancel. But for importing the data, of course there is testing is required. So I'm going to test that data. So click on this test. One comment is that everything seems valid. So now I'm going to import this data. So click on this import. Here the two records successfully imported. So now you can import the more courses also. You can see that imported courses on course dashboard. This is Computer Science Semester 3 and Computer Science Semester 5. It's pretty cool. In this way, you can import more courses like Computer Science Semester 7, Mechanical, Management, and that's. Now, I'm going to cover the second step, that how to import the batch. For that, click on this configuration, click on this batches, just click on this favorites, click on this import records. Now, I have to load file. For that, I have to import the template for batch. I'm going to click on it, and that template is already downloaded. I'm going to open it. I'm going to fill the data of that batch. Wait a moment. And that batch is Computer Science. It's batch 1 That code is Computer Science Batch 1, its start date, end date, and course is Computer Science Semester 3. I am adding one more batch, Computer Science Batch 2, its code, its start date, its end date, and course is Computer Science Semester 5. I am going to save this template and now I am going to load that file. Before the import of that batches, of course testing is required. So I'm going to test the data and one comment is there that everything seems valid. So I'm going to import that batch. Amazing! You can see that batch is already in the list of the batch. Computer Science Batch 1 and Computer Science Batch 2. You can see that batch on batch dashboard also. In this way, you can add more batches regarding to your courses. Now that second step, the how to import the data of batch is clear. Now I am going to jump to the third step, which is the import the data of different subjects. If courses are there, if batches are there, then of course the subjects of that courses are different. I am going to import the two subjects, which is data structure and the software engineering. For that, click on this configuration, click on this subjects, click on this favorites, click on this import records, and I'm going to download the template. I'm going to open that template. Now this template is already open. I'm going to add the data of subjects, which is data structure 001, its code 161, type theory compulsory, grade weight is 0, and course is Computer Science Semester 3. Now I'm going to add one more subject, which is software basic, its code 162, type is theory, subject type compulsory, grade weight is 0, and that course it's Computer Science Semester 5. Now I am going to save this information and going to load this information. That subject open. Before the import of that data, that is testing. Here one comment is there, everything seems valid. Now I'm ready to import this data. So import. Here I have created two subjects. Now you can see that two subjects, the data structure 001 and software basic. In this way, you can add your all subject of all courses. Now that third step is cleared and I'm going to jump to the fourth step, which is the how to import the data of students. Of course that campus contains the lots of students, so creating that students one by one is of course time consuming. So now I'm going to import the data of that all students. For that, click on this main menu, click on the students, click on this favorites, click on this import records. I have to load file, but of course template is required. I'm going to open this template and I'm entering the name of that two students whose data I want to import. That first data is Miss Emily. That Emily, for that Emily, its blood group, its nationality, language, first name is Emily, last name it's Thomas, and its middle name, email ID, its mobile number, birth date, now I'm going to add one more data, which is Mr. John. It's blood group, nationality, language, first name is John, last name is Smith, middle name and its email ID also, and mobile number and birth date also. Now I'm going to save this data. Now it's time to load this template. Click on this load file, student. Before the import that data, of course testing is required. So I am going to click on this test data. One comment is that the everything seems valid. So I can click on this import. The data of that students is already imported. Is Emily and John. In this way, you can import the data of all the courses. That's all for this video. Do like, share and subscribe to our channel. Stay tuned to get such more learning videos. To try our free demo, you can visit our website openeducat.org. Thank you so much.